It's time for some more Call of Duty live from Los Angeles. This is the Call of Duty Championship, our last main stage match of the day here on the Alpha broadcast. Xfinity and TCM all tied up, Astro.
Yeah, it's 1-1 apiece now, Puckett, in this best of five series. We're going to be heading to our first blitz here, and it's the only blitz in the series in this best of five, but TCM and Xfinity are going to be rolling through, trying to do whatever they can to take the map advantage. But let's take a look at the group play standings.
Absolutely. So Strictly Business, Vitality returns advancing from Group 1. We have eight groups here in Group 2. Complexity steamrolling Group 2. Vex Revenge, the Canadian squad, coming out in that second spot. They advance to the bracket. Same thing with Wild Gaming, the second Canadian team, as they join Team Caliber, who went 3-0.
Yeah, and then you have the Trident T1 Daughters hailing from Australia, going 3-0 in their pool. And then FaZe managing to pull it out in the end, going 2-1, with the only loss being to the Daughters. And then in group play, in group number 5, you have Immunity and Envious coming out of the pool. You had a three-way tie there where Envy, Intensity, and Immunity were all kind of in this one boat where they had to play a tiebreaker. And ultimately, Immunity and Envious come out of that tiebreaker.
More clutch, man. More clutch at Group 6. Rise Nation and Vitality Rises also already with big wins. Right now they are playing. Make sure you go catch their match. That'll be one that may determine this group. And then Optic Gaming, they're already up 1-0 over NSP. Epsilon will be playing NSP tonight as well. And Optic versus Epsilon will kick off our day tomorrow morning. Such a great series waiting for us when we wake up tomorrow.
Big time matchup in the morning.
I think it's the best match in group play, to be honest. One of. Definitely going to be a fan favorite, that's for sure.
There were some really good matches that we saw. I think FaZe Daughters was a really good one. I didn't get to catch it.
It was epic out there. I heard people screaming about it.
Yeah, and then even the FaZe matchup.
FaZe SK.
SK, that was nuts. I mean, that's an amazing match right there. Like, if you got to catch that one, you caught an amazing game. FaZe ultimately coming out with a win in that one, and that's what punched their ticket to the bracket.
Well, you see TCM representing the United Kingdom. On the other side, Xfinity, the four Americans, looking to take the swing game. We're going into game number 3. This is Blitz. Looking at the loadouts, we got Emtar, Remington, Emtar, Emtar for this TCM lineup. On the other side, same exact setup, 3 Emtars and a Remington in the hands of Dowd.
And here we go. Fast and Furious off the break of Sin. He is not caring at all. No regard for the TCM lineup in the middle of the map. He was trying to push as fast as he could, going for a quick cap, but that ultimately throws them off a little bit. And look, they're just pushing. Xfinity is just
they're in their base already. They already scored 1-0. Big win there would have made it 2-0, but Crozer falls. Meanwhile, Mud Dog continuing to put that pressure on, and they're just keeping one player back to play defense. That's Doubt's job with this Remington. So far, 2 kills for Doubt, make it 3. Phenomenal defense.
Yeah, so they position Doubt here at the blue bin, and that's a great spot for him to be as his teammates just bum rush the enemy capture point. I mean, that's
I love these opening strats. I love these opening strats.
That is all strategy right there. That's something you do not see teams do. And Doubt starting off hot, 5-0 now with the Remington, getting taken down eventually there, but Doubt was that key positional player for that Xfinity rush. He was the guy that's the defense. He did his job, and Xfinity jumps out to a 1-0 lead.
This is where it gets scary, though. Your initial rush is over. You lost that momentum. Can you stop the counter push from TCM? Look at the turn. Sin almost got it. Can Doubt get there in time? No, the far back spawn here. He's got to get out of there and push over to his base as fast as he can. And it looks like he will now have teammates to support. One player still in his base, though. Can he get this kill?
All right, Puckett. I'm not sure what's about to happen here. He does manage to get it and the cap. But if you're looking on the screen right now, which team will dominate on Blitz? We have a poll up for you. Make sure you tweet in to our Twitter account here. Let us know. Use the hashtag CODChamps and use the hashtag TCM Gaming if you think TCM is going to take this Blitz. Or use Xfinity Gaming if you think Xfinity's going to pull this one out.
Mad Cat and friends were up in the base. He's on a 6-point spree. Just bought 3 players running by. And this is sneaky. Mad Cat got to win the one-on-one. And this is a free blitz cap. He's got it. Just like that, they started 1-0 on Xfinity. Now down 4-1. Mad Cat looking to just run laps here from pawn into the base. Won't make it happen this time. Solid defense. But Moose is going to slide in for number 5.
And it looks like Xfinity's getting a lot of support from the fans out there. People are thinking Xfinity's going to take this one home. And you know what? It's not looking too great right now because TCM has come roaring back with five captures.
That was incredible defense. Three players all playing it perfectly, knowing where that push is going to come, setting up in sneaky corners, getting the kills before surging forward. Gunchy leading the charge here with the Remington.
Yeah, and now you see Gunchy pulling off some nice shots right here. And almost picks up that one as well. And you look at the scoreboard, Mad Cat, this player we should probably go check out right now.
You want to watch this man cap?
Look at this. Oh, my goodness. Mad Cat, you just did the nastiest thing right there to Xfinity.
He's getting angry, my friend.
Right.
Triple.
Yeah.
Give him the triple.
No.
Give him the triple.
No.
There's not your triple. It's just a double.
Mad Cat is just playing out of his shoes right now. Great job. And I think that TCM is looking so strong when he gets going. I mean, you don't want to be in the way of Mad Cat when he's 10-3, make that 12-3. And I think we got to stay on board with him, Puckett.
You know, I can't help but watch all these TCM players. Everyone's taking turns crushing. Moose is now putting the pressure on. But I'll go to Mad Cat for you. He's going to be trying to sneak in with Moose. And he looks like he's going to let Moose get that one. Meanwhile, Xfinity did go through for number 2 and 3. But just like that, Moose is going to give them a four-point advantage once again. Now it's Mad Cat starting to go for the cap.
Yeah, and you look at this, you see that Mad Cat's going to jump right in. I mean, they're giving Xfinity the overextend right now. And they're like, okay, well, if you're not going to play defense, we'll just trade this all day because we're up by four caps at the moment. And there you see another Xfinity player go in. So that was actually advantageous for Xfinity in the end.
Yeah, they caught up.
They caught up by one, yeah. So they're down three still. But I still want to stay on board with Mad Cat here because I think he's about to put on a show.
The kid's just swerving through the middle, taking fire, dodging bullets. Marky B with a double kill, going to clear the way. And now Mad Cat pushing it. You can see him. That white arrow on the minimap will get shut down. Meanwhile, it looks like everyone trying to double back except for Marky. He's going to keep pushing forward. And Xfinity won two of the three battles. Now they'll be attacking this base from TCM.
Yeah, and they're pushing really hard right now. So I think that Marky B is really in a good spot here to actually pick up a cap.
Marky B actually just went through.
Went
nice
through.
Defense.
Sorry.
Yeah, no, you're good.
I looked off for 1 second.
Can't ever look off, Ashton. Just don't worry. I'm just kidding. Meanwhile, we got Mad Cat trying to get another kill here in the middle. We'll get it at gas. Does he have time to get in the base? He's going to be sprinting for it. It looks like we're going into the half. 9-5 as Mad Cat. Can he get there? No. Solid defense from Doubt to end the round. From Xfinity, Doubt, a huge side, 14-6, playing all kinds of incredible defense at the start. Then they just got overflooded, but once they regained base control, Doubt shined once again. But they need to lock this map down. They cannot let Mad Cat and Moose get into the motel like they did last time.
I love the faces of Mad Cat that he makes after the game, too. You just see him, like, shaking his face.
You love this kid.
No, I mean, he's
I
awesome.
Understand why. He is amazing.
He's just hilarious. And the guy's he's a little bit of a wild character. He's a little bit of a wild guy. But at the end of the day,
he wore shades out on the main stage.
Yeah, he's an interesting character. I'll say that much, but he's an awesome dude.
Oh, absolutely.
I really enjoyed spending some time with him, getting to know him better, and he's just, he loves to laugh, you know? But look at his face right there. He just shook it off like, man, this is a lot of pressure, you know? And it is. There's a lot of pressure on both these teams.
And we got a player moving in to score. Enemy scored. Xfinity goes through a two-point lead now for TCM. It was much bigger than that. Moose backing up into a defender. A big kill here. And now let's see if Xfinity can push back out. It's close. 4 minutes, 16 seconds left. Xfinity could definitely steal this game away.
Definitely. And right now it's a two-point game. So let's see if Mud Dog can make a difference for his squadron here. He's actually coming out of spawn, and there are players for TCM positioned right around him.
Uh-oh.
I don't know how he – I don't know how he just split the uprights right there. But TCM now on the push. There's one player for TCM who's about to run a cap in right now. But
he's got three spawners on him. Marky B!
He manages to split three players from Xfinity.
He's like, I watch baseball. What's up?
Yeah, he was definitely sliding in there for that cap when those players from Xfinity knew he was coming. So very nice job by Marky B. And now you see TCM in the lead by three.
And the cat goes in, make it four after that. And look at this, pawn has been wide open. Gunchy doing a phenomenal job locking down, getting the kills, and that is just gonna clear the path for Marky B and Mad Cat. Gunchy, can he get another one? No, it's gonna be up to Marky B. Two defensive kills needed here, and here comes Xfinity.
Yeah, you gotta watch out for Xfinity right here. make it a push. So here's Mad Cat trying to play as much defense as he can in the meantime. And he's doing a pretty good job. Nobody's coming through right now. They know Mad Cat's there. And you see how scared they are. They just don't want to challenge him at all.
Hey, I don't want to fight that guy.
Yeah, he's definitely not one player you want to peek out on.
It's like seeing a UFC fighter at the bar. You just leave him alone. Mad Cat trying to push in, and he is going to get the two-piece. Look at that, jumping over Croster. Knows that his opponent can't turn while he's prone, and Mad Cat just showing off his player movement and his gaunt skill. This kid is hot right now, 19-10. Marky B, not the best of games from the kill calls, but also adding to those captures. Same thing with Moose.
Yeah, and that's why I just really like was stressing to stay on Mad Cat, because when the kid gets hot, he stays hot. And you know, you were going to miss those amazing plays that he's performing here and putting him up, putting on for us. He's showing us why he's one of the best players in the world, why he's regarded as the best player in Europe by many. So it's just awesome to watch that player when you get the chance.
And here we go. Almost an opportunity here for Xfinity. Can they keep it going? Doubt inside the base. Coming down to the last 2 minutes. 11-7. Doubt is going to go through. Xfinity needs to play some defense right now. Croster knows there's someone nearby. Gets one. Do they know about the second? Big one-on-one here for Doubt, and he is going to get the defensive kill as well. His teammate goes through a two-point game now in the last 2 minutes.
But if you look at the other side and you look at Mr. Doubt on Xfinity, he is 22-7 right now, slaying the world. And that is a big number for him. He is keeping Xfinity in this game by making sure TCM doesn't overrun them in their base. And that's big. If Doubt continues to slay like that through the end of this game in the last minute and a half, I think Xfinity has a great shot of tying this one up.
Doubt is going big. I know he showed a lot of love to Madcap, but let's show off Doubt for a moment. He knows he's got to get aggressive. His teammate just went through another cap here. I believe that was Croster. Mud Dog with two, Croster with four, and Doubt running out of ammo is going to have to switch over to the MTAR. His teammates continue to score, all tied up, and now 12-11 as one player did go through from TCM.
And you see Doubt immediately going for this win. He wants to win this game. TCM now in the lead by one, but Doubt is making that push. And let's see if he actually... Oh, my goodness. Doubt is putting the Xfinity team on his back right now. Doubt,
he's like, I'm going to go score. I can't get the kill. I'm going to score instead.
And there you see the score is now tied. And Doubt locking down the TCM spawn. This could be an Xfinity win here.
Oh, my goodness. There's two players in their base, though. And just like that, teams are trading 13-13. Final 40 seconds. One-on-one at the base. This one could determine a cap.
27-7 now on the board for Doubt. He's coming back through. There's another TCM player there. It was Marky B. And I believe he got through, so now it's 14-14.
And look at this. Moose is inside the Xfinity base. Xfinity inside TCM's base. Both teams trading. This one coming down to the wire.
Instant trade. 18 seconds left to go. Both teams just literally instantly traded right there on the caps. You see one player for Xfinity pushing up the middle of the map right now. He's actually got a good shot. Oh, this is Moose.
Can Moose get in?
But on the other side, there's a player for Xfinity.
Both teams playing defense, and Mad Cat will not get their time. We're going again.
Oh, my gosh. What a crazy map pocket.
Yo, remember when you thought Mad Cat was going to lock this game up?
Yeah.
And then Xfinity's like, no way, Hastro. We do not go down without a fight.
We have Doubt Cat.
Doubt versus Mad Cat. Doubt outperforming Mad Cat, 27-9, two caps, but arguably Mad Cat better game, six caps, 24-16.
Oh man, that was so close. You know, Mad Cat just wishes he had another half second.
Oh yeah, that two-piece inside the base, he had the game won. He just ran out of time.
Yeah, you know, this is a tough call right there. Do you go for that second kill or do you try to just jump in? But at that point, it's pretty much at that speed of play.
After 10 minutes,
you can't determine whether you go for the shot or go for the cap. You just go for whatever you can get.
Look at these stats one more time, guys. 24-16-6 for Mad Cat. On the other side, Doubt, 27-9, two captures. Team effort from Xfinity, same thing from TCM, as all players kind of shined at different moments, but there were definitely two stars shining above the rest.
Yeah, Doubt, it was just amazing that game. Holding down the overextend for Xfinity, you know, locking the TCM players. And for a lot of you that don't know what I'm talking about, the overextend is where the players will come off spawn for the enemy team and immediately take that route to your capture zone. So they're running as quickly as they can. That's called the overextend. And if you can lock that down, you're making sure that the players on the other team have to go around. you right. to get to your capture point. You're buying your team a lot of time to threaten the enemy's base. So Doubt did an amazing job there of locking down that overextend.
I got a bunch of tweets just now saying, what happens when this happens and teams tie on Blitz? You go another 10 minutes. We're going to see the same map, same game type. This one will determine who takes the lead in the best of five series.
We are going hard in the paint here at the Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox here in Los Angeles. We are in an amazing venue, first of all.
Right?
And now we have amazing matches coming out. Like,
I'd tell you where we're at, but it's a secret.
It is kind of a secret location.
I'm in a tent. That's all I said. All right, we're going into the next one, and who do you want to watch here, my friend?
You know what?
Mad Cat or Doubt? I'm giving you two options.
I'm going to go with the Cat, man. The Cat. I just want to see the Cat.
Because we got
Doubt had
delay
some nasty
here.
Plays. Oh, yeah, we're going to restart this one more time, but we had some nasty plays come out of Doubt there, obviously. I mean, the guy was killing it, but that play when we switched over to Mad Cat, pretty nasty.
Straight
nasty. Yeah, yeah.
Understandably so. I think everyone watching is now a Mad Cat fan.
He's no Kiwi, but...
He's no
Kiwi.
Is Kiwi your favorite?
I don't know, man.
It's so hard to have a favorite.
He got eliminated. Heart's broken. But if I had to pick a player right now that I really want to watch, it's probably Mad Cat.
Mad Cat?
Yeah. It's probably Mad Cat.
I'll show you some Mad Cat. We'll get that. We'll try to catch as many Blitz caps as well. I know we showed you a lot of slang in that one. We'll try and follow the objective. Just so you know, if you're just tuning in, you are in the final alpha match of the night. Xfinity going up against their toughest competitor in the group in TCM. TCM considered the best squad in Europe by many, if not all, right now. This squad looking so fierce at the EU finals, taking out some serious opponents leading up to this moment. Now they got to take out one of America's best in Xfinity.
Yeah, and so the Xfinity squad now in great position. You know, TCM had that game locked up. It was TCM's there to lose, and they managed to kind of relinquish a couple points there.
What went
Xfinity.
Wrong, if you think? Anything that you
I
could...
Think it was, I don't think anything really necessarily went wrong. I think what happened was Doubt was just such a force there at the end, locking them off because they were trying to trade.
Yeah.
And Doubt was locking it down.
He's
meanwhile,
like,
his
I'm
teammates
steal
were
wall.
Pushing.
You can't get past me.
Yeah, and his teammates were getting through, so they managed to get three good captures and, you know, bring it all the way back.
People always think Blitz is about the offense and being that attacker. The defenseman never gets the credit. You see Proofy doing it on FaZe. Mm-hmm. You see, you know, of course, Clayster doing it a lot for Optic Gaming. Doubt, that is his role here on Octane Blitz. So we'll see if he can keep it up because, you know, Mad Cat, he had some big defensive plays, but a lot more aggressive plays. And I want to see, is he going straight for the Blitz Cat? It looks like he wants to go Remington on Remington as he's pulling out the AR at the start.
Yeah, let's check this out. I mean, you got to wonder here how we're going to start this game off, who's going to get the momentum swing, and who's going to just jump out to that early lead. And that's so crucial here in Blitz. If you get that early lead, you can play a lot more fluid with what you want to do and work with your team to just dictate the pace and tempo of the game.
Already, first blood going to go to Gunshi, so... There is a player behind enemy lines, though. How did Mud Dog do this? Mud Dog, first 20 seconds, he says, I'll take a capture. Meanwhile, it looks like Marky B getting up top pawn. Same thing with Mad Cat. So two players up here, but look at this. Another player waiting to go through. 2-0 start in the first 30 seconds. What is going on here for TCM?
Well, that's an Xfinity push. If you remember on the first side, they just rushed all the way through. And you see what just happened right there is they knew Doubt was waiting around that corner. And I'm not sure if that was Doubt. Whoever that was, just around that corner, was just playing so patient. TCM had a lock on his location, but they didn't really want to challenge him right away. So finally, they get the balls too, and they go through.
Gunshi going to try and go through. Mad Cat's got to get some big kills in the middle. Spots one, but didn't see the one sneak underneath him. That means TCM will have no idea that Mud Dog is in their base once again. Mud Dog going for the kill and the cap. There is a 3-3, as just like that, TCM able to tie it up. Marky B, two caps. Gunshi with that third. And it looks like Gunshi going to need to play some base D. Does he see this player? Yes, he does. Goal line defense stops Crozer. Can he get the double?
No, he can't. And now you see that player. Who is that?
That's
Mud Dog going through for another cap. Mud Dog already with four captures in this game. Or excuse me, three captures
Man's
in this game.
Man's on a mission.
So that's nuts. You know, Mud Dog's already just kind of running around the map as fast as possible, trying to pull captures for the Xfinity squad. And it's a tie 4-4 game.
Mad Cat trying to lead the charge now. Marky B behind him. That's Gunshi as well. Mad Cat, three players in the base. Picks off one. Gunshi falls at the same time. Marky B, though, saying, thanks for distracting, Mad Cat. I'm going to cap from the backside. On the other end, you have two players pushing up, Crozer and Mud Dog, once again trying to set up. And both of these players here on defense, inside gas. What's the game plan here? It looks like Marky B could sneak in for another goal.
Look at this. He's coming through bottom hotel here. And he's actually going for the spawn trap. I like that play. It was a good idea, but at the end, you know, he was trying to open up too much right there.
There's a three cap situation down unless they stop Croaster and Sin. In goes Croaster. Sin will fall. So a 6-5 game at the start here. Gunchy playing some base defense. Makes sure that the base is clear as another teammate will go through. That was Moose's second cap.
Yeah, and now both teams are trying to fight for that middle map control. And here we go. Marky B picking up a big kill right there to open things up in the middle of the map. Now he falls. It's going to be Mad Cat and Gunchy left alive for TCM here in the middle. Mad Cat goes down. Gunchy now last alive. He is going to be at the gas station.
Not looking left, though, and that's where all the opponents are coming from. Croaster pushed up on that far right, just waiting for a challenger. And it looks like he is just waiting for Sin now to try and push as well. Croaster's going to make his move as Sin gets the distraction. Sin picks up two on the way in. Both players in position to score, and Sin just went through. I missed him, I apologize. But now, can Crow go?
Yeah, Crow's gonna have about 5 more seconds here before he can actually jump into this point. And TCM runs one in, but there you go. Crow puts another one in as well for Xfinity. So a minute and a half left to go, roughly. And Xfinity doing a great job with a one cap lead.
Doubt gets one. Knows that he needs more. A teammate in position to cap again. This is a 9-7 game, a 2-point advantage. He's got a sprint back home. He knows it. There is a player actually on the flank. And let's see what Moose can do here. He will have another one to his left. Ignores that kill. Smart move.
Oh,
gonna let
this
one go as well. And he will go through. Same thing with Xfinity, though. So still a 2-point game.
I love that play out of Moose right there. It's just smart play. You know, he's a great player. Somebody that we can actually spectate a little bit more too, just to see what he does. He makes great smart plays. He might not be the number one in slaying on the team all the time, kind of in the shadow of Mad Cat, but Moose is just a very, very solid guy to have on your squad.
Nice shots here by Doubt, but not enough. And we will see the defense now from Mud Dog up top. Hotel is going to get one. Can he get the second? Big shots there from Mud. Croaster trying to make his move, and let's see what Moose is up to. Currently 3-5, but 4 caps. How is he playing this one so sneaky?
Yeah, I mean, he's pushing. He's being the very hard aggressor that TCM needs right now. You're going to see, you know, TCM playing a little bit passive with Gunchy and Mad Cat, to be quite honest, even though, you know, Mad Cat appears to be playing a little more aggressive. But Marky B is actually going to be the other aggressor alongside Moose, I think. Let's see what they can do.
Doubt has to get some big kills because he is trusted with base D. One teammate coming off that spawn will be there to help. Doubt gets Marky B, so no caps coming in. Xfinity wanting to go in at the half with a big lead. Mud Dog, you can see here with Crosty, they are not letting anyone through.
Yeah, that's going to be a 2-cap lead for Xfinity. So continuing to keep this game extremely close, Puckett. But who would have thought that Xfinity, you know, I mean, a lot of people probably would have guessed that they would be great competition, but they look like they've had the lead most of this match, or so it seems, because we've played an S&D, and that was really the only time that TCM came steamrolling through on them.
So when it comes to the respawn game modes, Xfinity definitely can hang. They took domination with a nice second round comeback here in overtime blitz. This is the last side, hopefully, 8-10. Xfinity up by 2. Can they hold on to it? Their charger, that's Croaster, got taken down. Meanwhile, on the opposite side, Gunchy is going to be doubling back for defense. It looks like they're going to send Mad Cat on the attack.
Yeah, and I don't know. You know, the decisions right there by TCM, like, Xfinity always loves to bum rush right off the break, and they caught that. I would have loved to see Gunchy get more set up instead of just running through.
Moose is trying to kill. Meanwhile, Xfinity is capping. That was Sin who just went through. Actually, excuse me, that was not Sin. That was his teammate Croaster who went through, and now Sin set up for another cap.
Yeah, this is bad news right here for TCM, actually. This is really bad news. 13-9 now. TCM down by 4 captures.
Big kills from Mad Cat, though. That's a 3-piece. Mud Dog in the kill feed as well. Can Mad Cat get in? So many defenders in the base now coming off that respawn.
Yeah, he's trying to distract as much as possible. But in the meantime, there's another capture that goes in for Xfinity. They're just continuing to overextend and get into the TCM base. And TCM's just scrambling to try and get a capture here.
The defense is the difference here.
Yeah, that's what Doubt's doing, playing that lockdown role.
Meanwhile, it looks like Croaster and Mud Dog are just told keep charging, keep pushing forward. Doubt will take care of the middle. Meanwhile, it looks like you're going to see Sin also doubling back on defense. Sin actually with 4 caps so far in this one. 5 for Mud, 5 for Crow. Crow going for number 6 right now. And another big stop. Mud Dog with the defensive play here. And one more player at the base. It's Marky B sneaking through gas. Will make it 15-10, but Xfinity a 5-point advantage with 3:15 to go.
And there you see Marky B. Beautiful shot right there, taking that player off the cover spot. That was, I'm not sure exactly who that was. I believe it was Sin. But here we go. Marky B's pushing up now. And he has some advantage over here on this side of the map. Let's see if he can actually lock this side down and allow TCM to get a lane. That's what they need right now, Puckett. They need a lane to run through to get a string of
caps. I think they need
caps.
I mean, they're down
well,
six.
Well, yeah, of course. But you know what I mean? Like, you need to create a lane here where your team can create successive caps.
Well, Crowster's in their base again. This is going to be Crowster's six. Actually, that was Mudog. Excuse me. Crow right next to him with six caps as well. Both players trying to play some defense as they know the push is coming. That's Mad Cat. Once again, he picks up two and he's going through. Not the best slide. 17-12. 5-point advantage for Xfinity. 2:20 left.
Yeah, and now you see Mad Cat going for more blood right here. But it's just a trade fest right now, Puckett. And that's what I'm saying. Like, you have to have a player lock up the defensive side for your team and work together with two players creating those lanes. I mean, you have to start working together to try and pick up, make big plays, pick up two, three pieces and push your team through. But right now, you know, it's just a trade after trade, 19-14 now in favor of Xfinity. TCM not looking so solid right here.
And Mud came off that respawn, said, do I double back to my base or do I go for the cap? He tried to go for the cap, did not work. He does have teammates in the area. Will Xfinity be able to force this one through? Doubt giving up on defense, now playing offense. Will this come back to bite them? Only up 4 points now as TCM continues to score. And there's another player going through, Moose, just waiting for this one.
Well, they've managed to chip away by one. It's now a 4-point capture lead by Xfinity over TCM here. If you're just joining us, the map count in this series, it's a best of five series, is tied 1-1. This is map number 3 Blitz.
Overtime.
And it's overtime. We played this once already. Both teams tied. But look at TCM now. This is TCM in a bad position, or really good position for them, but bad position for Xfinity. Moose goes down. And I think that's actually going to clear them out. If Moose were able to get a spawn trap going there, TCM kind of could have got something going. But now with a minute left to go, Puckett, it's only a 3-flag deficit.
Xfinity could take the lead here. Just need to hold off Mad Cat and the boys for 50 more seconds. 3-point deficit. Mad Cat on your screen. MTAR at range will not win that one. Gunchy trying to answer back. And Gunchy, he's transitioned purely into a defensive role. Sees that there's no one on the right side. Going to now try and push up on the attack.
And they have about 7 seconds to get onto that flag or to that capture zone and put a cap in. So let's see if they can actually make that happen. Gunchy's just taking the long route, but he does get spotted. He's behind the dumpster here. This is going to be a big gunfight. He goes down, and
it looks like Xfinity
is going to take map number 3 here at the Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox. Huge gameplay out of Xfinity. Not many people would have foreseen this coming.
Doubt. Zero captures. He was the defenseman. He filled in when needed in the middle of the map. A huge first game actually of Blitz, but in overtime, Mud Dog, Crowster, and Sin just working as a 3-man attacking crew. Will go through. Mud Dog getting the team pumped up. The American squad Xfinity now in the lead in the best of 5. TCM knows they need this next game of domination.
And look how quiet TCM is right now. I mean, that's not a good sign at all. You do not want to be in that scenario. And let's take a look at the replays here. Puckett, there are going to be some good ones. There's a big kill.
Moose.
And a cap by Moose early on. Huge plays out of him. Mad Cat as well, picking up that kill and the cap. And I believe Mad Cat had a nice, nasty turn on right here.
Yeah, Mad Cat just ripping it here.
Boom, with the capture. Mad Cat just going off. You see him threatening again, but he just can't get through. And that was towards the end of the round right there. And there you go. Marky B getting in the mix as well.
Yeah, we watched a lot of TCM in this one because there were so many highlights from the Mad Cat. Here he is again, another two-piece. That's 4 two-pieces so far in this replay. But Doubt getting the final kill cam. We did not show him enough. He was actually the lead slayer in that first game. But in the end, Xfinity, Mud Dog, and the boys outplaying the objective. They did everything right there when they got up. They didn't stop trading, did not focus as much on the defense the second time around, and were able to squeak out the win in game 3.
Yeah, huge plays out of Xfinity. And now, can they close out TCM? That's the question. Can they actually do this and pull off the upset? This is the number one seed coming out of Europe they're playing against. You know, a lot of people saying all hail TCM. here they come and thinking that they're going to have a great shot at winning this thing, which they still do.
Right.
Even if they lose to Xfinity, they can still come out of the pool and do work. But right now, it looks like Xfinity is the better team.